Committee consideration sponsored by Senator Diaz. The first bill, Jennifer, you want to read?
An act to amend the general business law in relation to implementing the Immigrant Assistance Service Enforcement Act.
Do we have a motion for committee consideration?
So moved.
Motion from Senator Thompson, seconded by Senator Marcelino. Any questions or comments with regards to the bill?
Move it.
Move it. Okay, has everyone turned in their voting sheets, by the way? No? Okay.
I think you should have more.
Thanks, Joe.
Yes, we do have. We don't have anything for Senator.
All those in favor?
Senator Quadri, we don't have some.
Aye.
We're just going to tally it up. We need six votes in order for the bill to move on.
It's on number 94, Senator.
Mm-hmm.
One.
Without rec.
I think I'm without rec on that, too. I gave you that already.
Mr. Chairman, could I, this is my idea, I'm not part of the committee, right?
Yeah, absolutely, go for it.
Yeah, we are seeing, Mr. Chairman, we are seeing many immigrants being abused by people and organizations that open the door, offering their services. And Long Island, people have been indicted, so I'm going to be here, but I'm to be asking just to deal with the penalty for those kind of abuses against immigrants. So I think that it's a bill that is to protect people that really need protection and to stop those kind of abuses that we have been increasing daily. As the number of immigrants coming, more people are taking advantage of that abuses.
Senator Hazel Thompson?
Senator Diaz and I share a contiguous district, and we have very large numbers of immigrant populations living within them. And I have, too recently as last week, I have a letter from a woman and then a gentleman who claimed that this is happening to them, that they paid a substantial amount of money. And one of the reasons I'm very supportive of this bill is that because they make so much money, paying the fines is not a big deal for them. And so that increasing the fines, and I'm not normally one who likes to increase the criminal violations, but I think that we have to do something to send a message that this will not be tolerated. People are giving up their life savings and whatever little that they've accumulated coming to this country in order to believe that they're being given the proper support and assistance to get their green card. And they're being fleeced by people who have absolutely no ability to do that, nor any intent of helping them to do that. So I'm very supportive of this bill, and I think that that if we're really paying attention, a lot more of this is happening in communities of high levels of immigrant groups.
Senator Marcelino?
I passed a bill some years ago which allows for third-party intervention on behalf of people who are in a position that you are, applies RICO damages, treble damages, to the perpetrator, if you will, the employer who may be taking advantage or refusing to pay. I don't have the number with me or can, but if you check with my office, we can give you the number. It's on the books now. It was touted by most immigrant groups at the time, and by many labor organizations, one of the strongest labor bills passed in this state many years. So that bill is in force and is being used. But the key element is you could step in, anybody, a third party could step in and help these people out.
Good.
And
good.
Their status is not a problem in this particular piece of legislation. And it applies RICO damages to the employer who is doing the dream deed, so to speak. So it's there, if you want, we can look up the, I think it's called the Unpaid Wages Act. Way back when, but we can give you the specific number of the bill, or the chapter, if the case.
Thank you.
The final tally, six yes, two without rec, one no, bills reported. Next bill.
An act to amend the general business law in relation to notice requirements in the manufacture, assembling, and sale of roller skates and skateboards.
Do we have a motion for committee consideration?
So.
Seconded by Senator Marcelino. Any questions or comments? Senator Little?
Yeah, you know, nobody likes to see a kid get hurt. You know, I took my grandson shopping for his 8th birthday or 9th birthday, and we bought the one that has the wheels that, the skateboard that shifts all around, and called the next day to thank me and tell me he broke his arm. But, and now they said they have all the equipment, and we can't do something in New York State that we don't do in other states. So I'm against any kind of separate labeling. The buyer beware.
Any other questions or comments?
No.
Senator Squadron?
The refreshing. Do we, is use of these sorts of protective gear required in New York State currently? It's not. It's not. So we don't have, not like a helmet on.
We do for bikes.
Yeah. Well, that might make sense. It might solve some of your problems, certainly for people under a certain age. You know, these protective gear makes a huge difference.
If you see most professionals who do the skateboarding stunts, they're all wearing gear. They're all wearing knee pads, elbow pads, all the rest of that stuff. So, I mean, it's not like that information isn't available and that imagery isn't available to them. And quite frankly, any parent that doesn't, in my mind, take care of that themselves is a fool.
And we've seen a lot of foolish parents out there.
You're not going to legislate that away.
I know. I hear you.
That's my problem. I hear you.
But somehow it goes back to the same argument that Lanza and I were fighting about. How do you properly label the videos and some of those that just gives a heads up to parents about the level of violence that is present, and that's all this bill asks for, is just an awareness.
Remember the old Catholic movie.
And see, and you know, as an advocate of the consumer, I don't think that the buyer should be where. I think that we have an obligation, just like we didn't think for a long time we should put warnings about what's the hazards of cigarette smoking. Now, what have we learned 20, 25 years later? You know, that if we had been doing that, particularly for pregnant women and some others 25 years ago, we would have had fewer babies that are born with certain issues or with alcohol infant syndrome. So, I mean, it's a learning experience. And what we're saying is sometimes we just need to alert people to the dangers of things. And whether we think they should be smart or intelligent, you know, they're just not. Trust me, they're not. I was a pediatric nurse. They're not.
Sorry to circle back. If this was... Senator Little raised a concern having to be the manufacturer. They're interested. If this was on the seller, you know, these stickers could be stuck on by any seller at the point, any seller at the point of sale, and it wouldn't be an issue with manufacturing. It's, you know, skateboard is certainly big enough for a sticker like this. I'm going to vote without rec, because I think the manufacturer issue, since they're out of state, could end up being problematic and make this bill actually not pass constitutional muster. If it were on the seller, though, I would be an enthusiastic supporter of it. Again, because it's a sticker. Every restaurant needs to say employees must wash hands. You can make the sign yourself. You can buy one for $1.50. The same would be true with these stickers, and it would make a difference. So I'm going to vote without rec in hopes of it being put on the seller, not the manufacturer in the future.
And we got everyone else's sheets. Is anyone changing their vote? The final tally for Senate Bill 123 is four yeses, two without rec, five noes. Bill's reported. Next bill on the calendar.
Senate Bill 298, an act to amend the general business law in relation to providing telephone equipment with voice dialing functions to certain persons with disabilities.
Do we have a motion for committee consideration?
So moved.
Second? Second by Senator Marcelino. Any questions or comments on this bill?
It's a huge mandate.
Yeah, I just think if most people are trying to sell something, let people know what they have for sale.
By the way, we just been joined by Senator Adams a few minutes ago. Senator Adams is the ranking member here of the committee. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Excuse me, Senator Squadron, we don't have your voting sheet. Do you have it right there?
I do.
Okay.
Sure. Yes, I'm a no on this
one. You're a no on this one?
Okay. We're just adding up the sheets. Just give us 1 minute.
I'm a no also.
Right.
Those I changed it here.
Okay. No.
We have three yeses, three without recs, four noes, bills reported. Next bill on the calendar.
Senate Bill 499, an act to amend the general business law in relation to the fine imposed for certain violations relating to employment agencies.
We have a motion for committee consideration.
So moved.
Second. Second by Senator Marson. Any questions or comments on this bill?
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Yeah, this is another one of those bills that people are really abusing. Member of the community by opening storefronts and store promising jobs, and because people are in need of jobs, they go to this store, they pay money, then they find out that there's no job that they'd be taking advantage of. And I think that I'm asking heavy penalty for those kind of abuse.
Any other questions or comments?
Same comment as before, that same bill. I told you the Unpaid Wages Act will apply here as well. Treble damages to anyone who misrepresents or abuses someone who has gone to them for assistance. We've always had traditionally a very difficult time getting increased penalties with particular things. The other house doesn't like to be penalties at all.
So,
we've already got a law that will start that process where if you wish to intercede for them on behalf of someone who's complained to you, you can do it under the Unpaid Wages Act.
Any other questions or comments?
Yeah.
Just 1 minute, we'll just add it up.
Please note that I tried to give Senator Schillo back his pen, but he
left. I would keep it.
So we have six yeses, four noes, bills reported. Next bill on the calendar.
The next bill is Senate Bill 4074, and it's going to be referred to Commerce from here. It's an act to amend the general business law in relation to the selling, offering, for sale, or distribution of any electrical or extension cords with fraudulent seal for the Underwriters Laboratory.
Any questions or comments? Senator Squadron.
The training component here, it just seems.
I suppose you can move in a second.
Oh, I apologize.
Second.
Senator Squadron.
The training component in section two here seems, obviously the penalties on businesses, a lot of small businesses sell this. You have the local 99-cent store, you have, the local hardware store, which is struggling. And it seems the training component's difficult to sort of not fully defined, potentially. I think the idea here, I know that a fraudulent extension cord, making me worry about all the extension cords in my home, even just reading this bill, very serious issue. But I worry that we're creating a requirement that's hard to comply with for lots of, for small businesses that are really on the edge of survival.
It's online, though.
Yes, Section 6 of the bill provides that the training course would be available online.
So I'll be responsible for the training and education of its members. Section 2 doesn't refer to Section 6 explicitly, doesn't say that, what standard of reference to employees. We have a lot of hourly employees, part-time employees. So it's true that there would be a training component available online. The requirement in Section 2 is not linked to the training component in Section 6, as I read.
Well, I think that we're talking about two different things. I think that we're talking about, in Section 2, we're talking about that they're responsible for training their employees. And in Section 6, we're talking about people who have violated, who have been found to violate the provisions. And if you violate the provisions, then you would be required to take an online training course.
Right, but the concern is that Section 2 still, I mean, as you just say, and I think that's the point, doesn't really define what a sufficient training is that will relieve these businesses of liability, that will be in compliance with this, right? What do they need? At what point are they in compliance? At what point are they not in compliance? It's not clear. You know,
well,
over-aggressive enforcer could really be quite a scourge for small businesses here. And again, just if the training were more defined so that a small business could know, yes, I've complied, no, I haven't, it's not too burdensome, then my concerns would be allayed. But right now it seems like a requirement without a definition, which is very, very dangerous. You know, we often talk about mandates on small businesses and challenges. The toughest thing for a small business is to not know what they're supposed to do.
Any other comments?
Respectfully, Chairman.
We have nine yeses, one no. Bills reported. Thank you, everybody, for coming. Congratulations, Senator Diaz.